गुड मॉर्निंग। डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉलेजेट एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इंजीनियरिंग, मॉड्यूल 1 सेशन 2, हाईवे इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 18CB56। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इंडियन रोड्स एंड ऑल्सो द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ रोड्स इन इंडिया। इंडिया हैज ए लार्ज रोड नेटवर्क ऑफ ओवर 3.314 million kilometer of roadways, making it as the third largest road network in the world. That means approximately 33 lakh kilometer of roadways you can find it in India, and it is the third largest road network in the world. It has a density of 660 meter or 0.66 kilometer of highway per square kilometer of land, and the density of India highway network is higher than that of United States and also that of China. So US having a density of 0.65 and China as it having a density of 0.16, and also Brazil is having a density of 0.2. Let's see how the highway development took place in India. So there were a number of committees which were established and also which gave recommendations. Based on the recommendations, many organizations or the institutions were established in India, and also there were many road development plan similar to the 5-year plan or the 10-year plan period which is there in India. Similar to that, the for the highway you had 20-year development plan, road development plan. So to name a few, the highway development in India took place because of the recommendations of Jaikar committee. It was established in the year 1927. So based on these recommendations, you had the Central Road Fund CRF, Indian Road Congress, Central Road Research Institute CRRI, Motor Vehicle Act also came into existence, National Highway Authority of India NHAI, then first 20-year road development plan, second 20-year road plan, Highway Research Board, National Transport Policy, and third 20-year road plan. All these were came into existence. This is how, because of these committees' recommendation, because of these plans, the highway development took place in India. So first, let's see the important committee which was established before independence, which gave a recommendation how the roads has to be developed in India. So it is popularly called as Jaikar committee. It was established in India in 1927, that is before independence. Why this committee was established? Because after the First World War, the motor vehicle using the road increases the demand for a better road network. There was an enormous demand because of the World War, right? Many industries, right, many organizations were set up after the World War. So because of that, to cater the needs of those industries, employment and all those things, you wanted a better transport facility. Simultaneously, it demanded a better vehicles, better type of vehicle. So because of that, Motor Vehicle Act and also the number of development plans happened in India. So in 1927, Indian Road Development Committee was appointed by the government with Mr. M.R. Jaikar as the chairman. Road development in the country should be made as a national interest, since the local government do not have a financial and technical capacity for road development. So these are the recommendations of Jaikar committee. So the first recommendations of Jaikar committee is the road development in India should be treated as, or it should be taken as, a national interest, because the local government, whether you consider it as a state government or the municipalities, corporations or any state agencies, do not have the sufficient fund and also technical skill and capability, technical knowledge, persons and also the machineries, equipment, all those things, it may not be there with them. So because of that, right, they wanted to take this road development as a national interest. Second recommendations of Jaikar committee: an extra tax should be levied on the sale of petrol from the road users to create a road development fund. There should be a separate tax on the sale of petrol. So whatever the tax which has been collected, so that directly goes to the road development fund. To establish a semi-official technical institution to pool technical knowledge, sharing of ideas, and to act as an advisory body. So because of that, right, they wanted a semi-official and also a technical institutions on the matter of road development. So here I want to add one more thing. Tax was levied at 2.64 paise per liter of sale of petrol. That is, for every 1 liter sale of petrol, 2.64 paise was collected as a tax. At that time, it was very huge, 2.64 paise in 1927. Okay, so that amount directly goes to the road development fund that was exclusively used for the construction and also development and maintenance of roads in India. To create a national level institution to carry out research development works and in the field of consultation. The Ekar committee gave a recommendation saying that there should be a separate institution to carry out the research development work and also the consultation work on the matters related to the road or the highway. So based on the recommendations of this JCAR committee, right, so all the four recommendations of the JCAR committee were accepted by the then government, the British government, and it was implemented. So based on this JCAR committees, the recommendations of four JCAR committee recommendations, there were many agencies or the organizations were established in India. In that, the first organization that was established is Central Road Fund. It was formed in the year 1929. So what are all the functions of this Central Road Fund is, the consumer of petrol were charged an extra levy of 2.64 paise per liter of petrol to build up the road development fund. So as I told you earlier, 2.64 paise during that 1927 or 29 period, it was a very good amount, right? So that amount was collected for the development of road development. From this 2.64 paise, 20% of the whatever the total amount that is collected in this road development fund, out of this 20% of the annual revenue is to be retained with the central government for the research and experimental work expenses. Remaining balance 80% is distributed to the various state according to the consumption of petrol or the revenue collected. So when you had this 2.64 paise per liter of sale of petrol, right, so all over India you can see there is an enormous or a huge amount of the consumption of petrol has been happening. So whatever the money that was collected from that 2.64 paise as a tax from the sale of petrol, that was pooled into a one fund, what is known as the road development fund. So in that fund, out of that entire amount, 20% was retained by the central government to carry out the administrative work, to carry out any other research and other work expenses related to the fund. So the remaining 80% was distributed to the all the various state according to the revenue collected or according to the actual amount of petrol consumption. Distribution of 100% of this on the sale of petrol, right? So out of this, 57.5% for national highway, 30% for state highway. So this is the recommendations which again was given by MORTH, that is Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. The remaining 12.5% for the safety of work on railroad crossing. So in India, in many places you have the railway crossing, right? So whenever the road goes, right, so even you had the junction or a meeting with the railway, so you need to provide a safety during in those junctions, that is railroad crossing or the junction. So the 12.5% amount was spent on safety of rail and road crossing. 50% cess on diesel for rural development. So the 50% of whatever the cess that they have collected from the diesel, that should be exclusively used for rural road development. So again, based on the recommendations of JCAR committee, one more organization was established in India, that is Indian Road Congress, popularly called as IRC. It was established in the year 1934. Central semi-official body known as an IRC was formed in the year 1934. So what are the functions or the duties or responsibilities? To provide a national forum for regular pooling of experience and ideas on the matters related to the construction and maintenance of highway. So all the experienced persons, all the ideas which were there on the construction maintenance of the highways, they were provided by this Indian Road Congress, IRC. It is an active body controlling the specification, standardization and recommendations on material design of roads and bridges. So in India, you can say that whatever the specification, whatever the code, whatever the standardization, whatever the design that we are doing in the construction of highway, it is purely on the basis of recommendations of IRC's guideline. IRC every year, right, depending on the different types of category, depending on the different types of activities that we involve in the road or the highway, IRC releases the code book, right? So based on the code book, right, all the construction activities will be carried out. So in India, IRC is the one which gives the specification and also the guidelines for the construction of road. It publishes journal, research publication and standard specification and guidelines. It provides a platform for expression of professional opinion on the matters relating to road and road transport. If anyone has any professional experience, knowledge, any ideas, definitely they can share those ideas in the journals and also the research publications of Indian Road Congress. Based on the recommendations of this JCAR committee, one more act, it was not a committee, it is an act. It is an act which is passed by the parliament, that is both the houses of the parliament, both the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. So it was formed in the year 1939 to regulate the road traffic in the form of traffic laws, ordinance and regulations. So whatever the rules and regulations which are there in India, it is mainly due to the act, that is by Motor Vehicle Act. The Motor Vehicle Act will decide what are the guidelines, what are the standards, what are the specifications, what are the rules that needs to be followed whenever somebody is driving the vehicle. Three phases primarily covered are control of driver, vehicle ownership and vehicle operations. So the Motor Vehicle Act covers control of driver, right? This is how, right? Whatever the driving license you get, whatever the violations, right? If somebody does the violations whenever they are driving, the penalty, right? Just to give an example, riding the vehicle without wearing the helmet, bypassing, right? Then signal jumping, violation of all these rules and regulations, the provisions are made in this Motor Vehicle Act. It was revised in the year 1989 and recently, even in 2020, the Motor Vehicle Act has been revised. Another agency, CRRI, Central Road Research Institute, the headquarters is in New Delhi. It was established in the year 1950. So what are all the duties or the responsibilities of the CRRI? To engage in carrying out research and development project related to highways, design, construction and maintenance of roadways and runways, traffic and transportation, planning of mega and medium cities, management of roads in different terrain, improvement of marginal material. So marginal materials are the waste material. So whatever the material we get from the industries, right, even those material we can effectively and efficiently use in the construction of highway. Utilization of industrial waste in the road construction, landslide control. Usually this occurs in the hilly area, right? So there may be a landslide, that is the structures which are adjoining to the road, it may fall due to the heavy rains, or it may fall due to the safety aspect, right? So it may not be having a sufficient protection wall, right? So because of that, there may be a landslides. Then ground improvement and environmental pollution, road traffic safety. This also is another important thing, right? The vehicle and also the persons who are driving on the vehicle, they need to follow the some safety standards. Another important agency, right? The Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, popularly called as a MORTH, M-O-R-T-H, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. So what are all the functions of MORTH? Planning, development and maintenance of national highways in India, right? Then extends technical and financial support to state government for development of state roads and the roads of interstate connectivity of economic importance. So interstate, the roads which are connected, and it is also having economic importance, right? All these roads are controlled, or they give the standards specification for the construction of the roads. Evolve the standard specification for roads and bridges in the country. It stores the data related to the technical knowledge on roads and bridges. One more agency, Highway Research Board, popularly called as a Highway Research Board or HRB. To ascertain, so what are all the functions? To ascertain the nature and the extent of research required in the area of highway or the road. To correlate research information from various organizations in India and abroad. To collect all the information from the research activities which are going on the highways, and to dissipate that information to the public through the help of a journals and also the research paper. To collect and correlation of the services. To collect result on research, to analyze the consultative services or consulting services. If any agency wants some consulting agents services, HRB is the one which is going to give. That is, any agency here is private agency, or any state government, or any government wants the some technical information on the construction of roads and bridges or maintenance of any road or bridges, definitely it gives a some consultative services. Moving on, right, we come to the classification of roads. So the roads in India are broadly classified based on season. So based on season, the road is classified into two categories. One is all weather road, second one is fair weather road. So what is the meaning of all weather road? It can be accessed except at major river crossing where interruption to traffic is permissible. So that means the road can be accessed throughout the year. That is, you have this three seasons in India, right? Summer, winter and monsoons. So there may be some interruption of traffic in the monsoons. Apart from that, there is no interruption to the traffic in those roads. So such type of a roads, they are called as all weather roads. Fair weather road, traffic may be interrupted during monsoons at causeways. So still in India, you have these many places where some villages are in some part of the road cannot be accessed during monsoon. Why? Because of causeways, because the water will be flowing over that road. So there will not be possible for the vehicles or the traffic to move on. So such type of a roads, they are called as a fair weather road. So I just repeat, based on the season, they are classified into two categories of road. One is all weather road and fair weather road. All weather road, which can be accessed throughout the year or on all the seasons of the year, whereas the fair weather road, the traffic may be interrupted only during monsoons. Second category, or the second classification, based on the type of carriageway, paved roads. Paved roads are hard course with at least waterbound mechanism, WBM road. So you have this paved road and unpaved roads. So what are paved roads? The paved roads are the hard in nature, hard course with at least one waterbound mechanism. So whatever you see in the village roads in India, usually the people call it as a jelly road, right? So the jelly road, you call it as a, technically we call it as a waterbound mechanism, WBM road. So that type of a road, if you have that jelly road, you call it as a paved road. based on the surface or type of surface provided, surface road which are provided with bituminous or concrete, those are called surface road, and surface road which are not provided with bituminous or concrete surface. Okay, so surface road and unsurface road. So what is a surface road? Which are provided with either a bituminous layer or a cement concrete layer. Unsurface, any road which is not provided with a bituminous or a concrete surface. So based on traffic volume classification, it is classified into heavy, medium and light. Based on load or tonnage, it is classified into class 1 or class 2. It is also called as class A load and class B load, or tons per day. Class A or class B, it is nothing but tons per day. So moving on, we come to the very important classification of highway or the road, that is based on location and function. So the highways or the roads in India, based on location and function, they are classified into 5 important categories. First one is national highway, popularly called as NH, state highway, also known as SH, MDR, that is major district road, ODR, other district road, and village road, VR. So based on location and function, the roads in India are classified into national highway, state highway, MDR, ODR, and so again, this system was little bit modified, which is known as a modified system of highway classification. So they categorized into primary, secondary and tertiary. So primary roads include expressways and national highways. Secondary roads includes state highway and MDR, major district. Tertiary, ODR, other district road and village. So let's see what are all the features of these different categories of road or the classification of roads. Expressways, this is the superior quality of roads that you can see in India, right? It is more superior than your national highway. So what are all the features? Heavy traffic at high speed of 120 km per hour. One can travel at a design speed of 120 km per hour. You can see here, right? How beautifully the expressway has been built. So it will be having an uninterrupted vehicular traffic movement, and also it will be very high. It will be having a superior quality. The construction quality will be good. Land width 90 meter. You can see here. I just posted a one Mumbai Pune expressway. Right. Width is 90 meter. Very long or very wide width. Full access control, right? So nobody can come in between. Uninterrupted traffic movement, you can see. Connects major points of traffic generation. No slow moving traffic is allowed. No slow moving, right? All will travel at more than 100 or 120 kilometer speed. No loading, unloading and also parking. The vehicle will not stop in the middle for loading and unloading, and also there is no parking. Parking is allowed only at few designated places. Otherwise, there is no parking on this expressway. So, let's see what are all the features of this national highway. National highway are the main highways running through the length and breadth of the country. Our entire India is connected by national highways. If you move from north to south, if you move from east to west, all the parts of India are connected by national highway. So, it connects major ports, foreign highways, capital of large states, large industrial and tourist centers, including the road required for strategic movement for defense of India. So it covers all the important state capital, all the important industrial area, tourist places, right? Everything is connected by national highway. The national highway has a total length of in India approximately 70,548 kilometer length. The Indian highway covers 2% of total road network of India, which carry 40% of total traffic. So compared to the entire total road network, the national highway constitutes only 2%. But this 2% of national highway carries 40% of traffic. Whatever the traffic which is there, out of that 40% is carried by national highway. Usually these national highways are designated as a number: NH1, NH2, NH3, NH4, etc. So just to name a few: Delhi, Ambala, Amritsar, the places which are connected by this, they are called as National Highway 1. Similarly, Jalandhar to Srinagar and Uri is denoted by NH1A. You can have these sub categories like A, B. I think only there are few roads are named like this. Otherwise, usually the National Highway Authority of India names this national highway as NH1, NH2, NH3, etc. The longest highway in India is NH7, which connects the stretches of Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh to Kanyakumari in southernmost point of Indian mainland. The shortest highway is NH47A, which stretches from Ernakulam to Kochi, which covers a total length of only 4 kilometers. So I have just shown you the national highway, right? So this is popularly called as a golden quadrilateral. The golden quadrilateral is a total length of 5,846 kilometers. It was constructed under NHDP, National Highway Development Program. So it covers Bombay, Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai. The golden quadrilateral scheme connects the very important cities in India through national highway, that is Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai. NH2, Delhi to Kolkata. So Delhi to Kolkata, 1453 km. NH4, 7 and 46, Chennai to Mumbai, approximately 1290 km. NH5 and 6, Kolkata to Chennai, 1684 km. NH8, Delhi to Mumbai, 1419 km. State highways, they are the arterial roads of the state. So they are the important roads in the state, connecting up with national highways of adjacent states, district headquarters and important cities within the states. So you can have the national highway and also the state highways running interstate, right? Both from one state to the another state, and also the highways which may be connecting with the adjacent states and also the district, and also the very important district headquarters within the state itself. Total length of SH in the country is 137,119 km. Speed is 80 km per hour. So that is, they are designed for a design speed of 80 kmph. That means one can safely travel at a speed of 80 kmph. MDR, major district road, important roads within the district. So in each district you have what is called as an MDR, major district road, serving the areas of production of markets and connecting those with each other or with other major highways. So the MDR connects the SH, could be like this. The MDR may be connecting to the state highway and the state highway may be connecting to the national highway, or even the MDR itself may be directly connecting to the national highway. It depends on the locality. India has a total length of 470,000 km of major district. Speed, one can easily and safely travel at a design speed of 60 to 80 kmph. Coming to the other category of road, that is ODR, other district road. Usually these ODR serves the rural population in India, rural areas of production, and providing them with the outlet to market centers or other important road like MDR or SH. Okay. So that is, the villages, they are connected by ODR, and also wherever there is an important marketplace, those areas or those centers will be connected by ODR. Design speed is 50 to 60 kmph. Finally, we come to the last important one, that is the village road. So what are these village roads? They are the road connecting the village or the group of villages with each other with the nearest road of higher category. That is, these village roads can connect the ODR or the MDR. And India has got 26,50,000 kilometer of ODR and VR. Out of this, 33,15,253 kilometer of all types of speed is 40 to 50 kilometer. So the speed is very less compared to your national highway or the state highway. So it is basically for the roads which are connecting in the rural areas. So I just repeat. So the important classification of road based on the function and also the location is national highway, state highway, MDR, ODR and VR. MDR is major district road, ODR is other district road, VR is village road. Let's see some of the multiple choice questions on the whatever the topic we discussed today. First one, the Indian Road Congress was formed in the year 1928, 1934, 1929, 1930. So the answer is B, the year 1934. A research organization that was formed for the research and development organization works related to the roads was Indian Road Congress, Central Road Research Institute, Central Road Fund and NHAI, National Highway Authority of India. So the answer is B, Central Research Institute, that is Central Road Research Institute, CRRI. The organization which stipulates the guidelines with respect to the road construction activities in India are IRC, Indian Road Congress, MORT, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, C, both the above, D, HRB, that is Highway Research Board. The answer is C, that is both IRC and Ministry of Road Transport and Highways have the standards and specifications for the construction of road activities in India. Central Road Fund was established in the year, which year? 1928, 1934, 1929, 1930. The answer is C, that is in the year 1929. M.R. Jaikar Committee was set up in the year 1927, 1928, 1934, 1929. Answer is A, 1927. Which one is not a classification of roads based on tonnage? Class A, Class B, Class C, both Class A and Class B. So here you can see not a classification. So the answer is C, Class C. You have Class A load and Class B tonnage. Okay, tonnage based on the tonnage. The share of state government in Central Road Fund is 20%, 40%, 80%, 100%. So the answer is C, 80%. So 80% will be distributed to the different states, whereas 20% will be retained by the central government itself. The share of central government in CRF is 20%, 40%, 80%, 100%. The answer is A, that is 20%. The road connect the village to other village or nearest district road is NH, SH, VR, VR. The answer is C, that is other district road connect the road to the village from one village to the another village in the nearest district. The road connect the areas of production and market with either state highway or railway, MDR, SH, ODR, VR. The answer is A, that is major district road connect the areas of production and markets with either a state highway or with a railway. Thank you.